allowed to go outside where you live? Then get something to cover your body, like the new zip-up hoodies, as well as shirts, tanks, leggings, fanny packs, and yes, masks, because they're going to be wearing those fucking things until this time next year. Check the description for a link to my merch. You can say what you want about Smash Mouth, as if you needed my permission, but they've managed to stay relevant through 4 decades, whether good or bad, through their own doing or not. Of course, in the late 90s, you couldn't turn on the radio or MTV / Much Music without hearing Walking on the Sun or All Star. In the 2000s, All Star, as well as the cover of the Monkees' I'm a Believer, appeared in Shrek, giving them an even larger audience. In the 2010s, meme culture glommed onto All Star like white girls to pumpkin spice lattes and true crime documentaries. Perhaps you remember a very large man performing the lyrics over top of the instrumentals of other songs? And in the 2020s, Smash Mouth played a concert for bikers, because as we all know, bikers love late 90s, early 2000s poppy alt rock. A concert, by the way, that the news claims is responsible for like 250,000 new cases of COVID. By the way, Drowning Pool performed at Sturgis as well, and I haven't heard one, wow, I guess they really want to let the bodies hit the floor, joke on the internet. Not one. Come on, internet, get your shit together. So, the band that's got the worst ratio of tough-sounding name to pansy-sounding music, move over, five-finger death punch, recently got into it with some radio announcers. I'll just read you their tweet. Yo, at Alt-1053 Radio, can you stop talking over the fucking songs? This isn't 80s AM radio. You are disrespecting the artists. Do you think they want your stupid voices as their intros? That's one of the reasons All Star starts off with vocals. Let's go! Hashtag Bay Area Unite at radio.com. What Smash Mouth is talking about is called hitting the post in the industry. It goes a little something like this. 1021 CKOK the Rooster. Hey, coming up, we're giving away a free hot and ready pizza from Little Caesars with our cheesy challenge. You know you want it. We know you want it. We'll tell you how to win right after Smash Mouth. Here's Walking on the Sun. It ain't no joke. Announcers fucking love this. You have no fucking idea how much they love this. People who have been in the industry for 20 years still give themselves a little high five in their mind every time they do it. And so, a bunch of radio industry people got upset at Smash Mouth in the replies. Excuse me, I loved All Star, but your take is trash, and I get paid a very modest amount to talk about either you or our station over those intros, so you can have all the damn seats. I don't tell artists how to do their shows or how their industry works. I also don't see Smash Mouth on my paycheck. Yes, they do want our voices over the intros. That means we're playing their songs. And the radio station weighed in as well. We also now only play 2 minutes of commercials at a time. It's our hashtag 2 minute promise, which is quicker than it takes for someone to name a Smash Mouth song that wasn't in Shrek. Wow, got him! Now, I've always assumed that people hate radio announcers, and part of the reason I went to school for radio broadcasting was because I thought I could be better, that people would enjoy listening to the things I had to say, and wouldn't just tolerate me because a good song was coming up. And then I created a YouTube channel where all I do is talk, and a video where I make fun of a bunch of songs for 15 minutes got watched 10 million times. So, I think I did okay. But I wanted actual people's opinions. So, I asked some of my Patreon subscribers on Discord a few questions about radio, with Buckley's Unfocused Focus Group. Now, I will admit, this was far from a scientific poll. I had 10 people in on it. 9 of the 10 said they still listen to the radio, mostly in their car or at work. No one said they listened at home. So then I asked, what do you like about listening to the radio?
The sense of discovery for new songs that I might enjoy.
Possibly finding new music.
I'd say that the musical discovery was always good.
Sometimes, like, a song that I actually do like will pop up on the radio.
Being able to call in and request songs.
In my line of work, it helps break the silence and monotony of hard labor. I like that a lot of the time it'll play a song that you might have liked but forgot about, or a new song you now enjoy because you wouldn't have looked for it otherwise.
Like, when there's good hosts, I love listening to them. I find it really entertaining.
The radio personalities that they always have a lot of good stories or humorous stories.
Everything is super specific to this area, so it's a lot of just everything that's happening in town.
As you can see, most of the people said they liked the music aspect. I only had a couple who said they really liked the announcers. So, then I asked them this question. On a scale of 1 to 5, 1 being, it sounds fucking dumb, 5 being, it's so cool I nearly jizz every time. What do you think of announcers talking over the intro of a song and stopping just as the vocals kick in? These were the answers I got.
I definitely give it a 1. It does not make me want to jizz in any way, shape, or form.
I'd have to give it a 1 as well. Like, sometimes it's good if they're covering something interesting, but generally I want to hear the whole song.
A 1, because if I'm going to listen to music, I want to listen to the songs, not you. You have your own talking time for a reason.
I'd give it a 2, I guess.
Can I give it like a 0.5? Is that allowed?
I would give it a 0 if I could.
Yeah, that's a 1.
Definitely a 1. It's just terrible. I've yet to see it done well.
I definitely give it a 1. I've never jizzed once when Serious Hip Hop Rate Nation keeps creating documentaries over their songs.
So, again, not overly scientific, but as you can see, the average person doesn't think it's that cool. But as I said, radio people, they fucking love it. Radio has and always will talk the intros. It's a part of the art of radio, and it's what creates the forward momentum. There are a zillion options for people to access music without any announcers or commercials attached to it. Radio is all about that momentum, and not talking the intros means that radio plays fewer songs, costing artists, in quotes, a fortune. I have to second blank on this. Talking to the post over an intro does create momentum. Listen to a statin where they don't and it sounds like a high school music appreciation class. The other aspect of talking the intro is it's fun for the jock, and the audience can tell when you are having fun. If you are having fun, they will get caught up in it as well. This is simple science, lol. That's why your radio hosts always choose wacky over cool or interesting. They believe it's simple science that if they're being goofy, whoa, hey now, that was Smash Mouth, and you could be an all-star too when you play In It to Win It every hour from 5 a.m. to 9 a.m. with Fat Freddy and the Chew Crew, weekday mornings here on Wilmington's home for classic hits, Zest 95.7. They think that makes you feel like you're having as much fun as they are, and doesn't make you feel like punching through your radio in an attempt to hit them. But they believe talking over the intro is an art and creates forward momentum, not realizing that time being linear creates forward momentum, that things will move forward regardless with radio. It's a medium with no rewind button. Someone listening can only continue on or stop. They can never go back. So if a band is like, hey, don't talk over our shit, we hate that. It's interesting that the industry's response is, fuck you, we made you relevant. When the reason people listen to the radio is generally for the music. And especially now when radio needs music more than music needs radio, although a few from my focus group said they like finding out about songs via the radio, as someone in the industry admitted, there are a zillion options for people to access music without any announcers or commercials attached to it. Type in any genre or even just new music into Spotify and you'll find a number of playlists that will almost definitely have something in it where you'll go, huh, that's pretty cool, I should see what else this artist does. And at no point will it be interrupted by someone going, hey, coming up, you'll never guess what two condiments they're sticking in the same bottle now. You thought mayo chup was weird. Well, wait till you hear about this. Right after Pearl Jam, here's Evenflow.